TWM podcast.
Total Bella's time as we recap Bryan and Brie's issues and Artem panicking about engagement. We see this week about Bryan's wild trip. Nikki's going to learn Russian and Artem buys a ring. And the opening bit we see is that Nikki has bought Brie singing lessons because she can half sing. Kind of sing. I say sing. She yells into a mic with some form of tune.
Yeah. She can sing if she wants to go down the heavy metal route.
It was very strange. Nikki was like, Brie can really sing. And they showed that thing and she literally just goes, it's rumor. Like, really loud. All she does is loudly and then go up an octave. That's not singing.
Yeah, that's not singing.
The guy in there is just gassing her up massively, almost as if they've paid him a lot of money.
Oh, they clearly pay him a lot of money.
Like, chuck a couple of grand and I'll tell you that you're a great singer. They do all the King's Speech stuff and the vocal warm-ups, and then we cut to the Bella twins interviewing the guy from Headspace, which I have heard of. That's an app off the internet.
Well done.
And Brie talks about getting away from all the madness leading up to their trip to Sedona, her and Bryan. They end up talking Russian and Nikki knows no Russian. I just thought, by the way, the guy from Headspace just flexes that he knows Russian straight away.
He proper was like, oh, you don't know Russian, guy? Well, watch this, bitch.
Yeah. And then what I love is, like, Brie doesn't even know any Russian. And then the guy just goes, well, I did live in Russia for a few years. It's like, yeah, don't mug your sister off. How dare you not learn Russian in the year you've been going out of a Russian man?
You'd learn something, surely.
I imagine it's one of those things. We had this chat a few weeks ago with this stuff. Actually, it would have been during Total Bella's, like one of the first episodes. The first thing you learn is the rude words.
We did.
I'm pretty sure she's learned like the swear words and stuff. And Nikki thought the Baltic Sea was in Mexico, which you can't laugh. You refuse to believe that Qatar's a real place.
I'm still refusing to believe that Qatar is a real country. It doesn't exist.
Tom, who does the SmackDown podcast a few years ago, moved from Wales to Qatar. And we'll be told Kim thought we were joking because we thought we made up the place known as Qatar. She genuinely didn't think it existed. That's a true story. And she's laughing. That's why she's not having a go at me.
I'm just really bad at geography.
Don't worry. I spoke to my girlfriend yesterday about certain places in America. She's half American, didn't know where they were. And I was like, how? She went, I'm not good at geography. I went, there's a difference between not being good at geography and not knowing, like, the states of your own, of the place where half your family's from. Anyway, away from me roasting my girlfriend, Bella's and their mum have coffee and talk about Brie and Bryan's issues, and Brie talks about them growing apart. They do the classic reality TV edit of, like, Nikki asks Brie an important question. It's a big pause, and then they just change subject, which I always love.
That's actually a normal girl thing.
No, but it's like, they do that thing, don't they? It's like, what do you think about this serious subject? And it's just, like, a bit of a drink, and then they sharp cut to another part of the scene. So it's almost like they've been thinking about it. It's just such a reality TV trope. And she talks about missing the quiet time and admits that they could be happier. And it's that point. It's like, even I know from watching clips of, like, the old season of Total Bellas, is I can see Bryan's, like, thing, because he's very much always been, like, a hippie, like simplistic, nihilistic guy.
Yeah.
And Brie was that when they first met. Or almost to the point where maybe Brie was a little bit like that because she liked Bryan and decided to, like, lean into that hippie boho girl. And now she's, like, working mum. She's basically like Nikki, but a little bit more hippie, like mini hippie. So I can easily see why Brian's like, well, you were like this when we first met, and now you've almost gone back on everything that we planned alongside because you want to be, like, this businesswoman. It's one of those things. And they talk about Sedona. And obviously that's going to come to a head later. Artem and Bella's go to a bar. Brian no-showed. And don't worry, Johnny Ace is there and he's going to do some talent relations and text Brian and be like, why are you not here? They're taking out of your pay. We find out that Artem's parents are coming to France because they're all going to France next week because it seems every season has to end with them in France for reasons.
Vive la France!
It happened last year. That's where all the stuff about potentially breaking up with Cena happened. And Nikki is nervous, and Artem has gone bright red because he's now bricking it that his parents are going to meet his girlfriend. Brie can't keep her fucking mouth shut because she immediately turned around mid like dinner and tells Big Johnny and Mummy Bella about it right in front of them, for fuck's sake.
Yeah, she was sitting right next to Nikki, wasn't she? Like, I'm not dumb in saying that.
No, like, she was sitting next to him and she just turns to one side and goes, she's distracted. By the way, secretly, Artem's going to buy her a ring and propose. She can't hear me, even though we're 2 feet away from her and she's only slightly leaned over into her boyfriend. It's just, yeah, it's just, it's, like, just keep your mouth shut. Wait, like, go outside and have this conversation. You're right next to your sister. Brie is worried that Nikki will say no. And the mum is willing to sell a ring from one of her many, many marriages. Artem and Nikki are talking garden stuff, and we find out that Artem finally has a job. He's off the job seeker's allowance.
Yay! Well done.
He hasn't got to go down the job office? What's it called? Whatever it's called. I can't remember. It's been ages since that happened to me.
I can't remember what it's called.
What's it called? Job centre. That's the one.
Job centre, that's it.
We forgot the word job centre. It's not even a word, a phrase. And then Mum and Brie talk about Nikki and Artem's possible engagement, and Mum says she's going to go to France to back her up just in case. Mum gets annoyed that no one asked her permission for Brian's...
Oh my God, their mum is such a dick, like, honestly.
It's all about me! I'm the best, I'm
she
the mum.
She tries to make everything about her, doesn't she? You don't, like, I know...
The big mum!
You're changing traditions and stuff, but you don't ask the mother permission, you ask the father. The father gives her away.
Yeah, the only thing you ask, you would only ask the mother, is if the father was, like, literally not there.
Yes.
Yeah. And I know he left and had problems, but the father is still there. I also, one of my favourite parts of this, again, Birdie just being an MVP. She's an MVP in this entire episode.
She really is.
Because Nikki and Brian leave to go to Sedona, and Birdie's just more than okay. This is like, we're leaving now. She goes, okay, bye-bye.
Bye.
Couldn't give a shit that they're leaving. On the way, Brie reads a book about star signs, and they talk about Scorpios being massive perverts. I don't believe any of that stuff. Don't know whether it's true. Is that true?
Not one of my best friends is Scorpio. She's just a sex perv, honestly.
So there we go.
Never known someone to be so sexual in my life.
Gonna name names?
I know, because if she listens, she'll kill me.
They go to where they went to get married, and they reminisce on that day, and Brie kind of...
That was cute.
It was lovely, and they realise they need to put the effort in. Nikki, we then cut back to Phoenix, and Nikki wants to learn Russian and learn the culture, and Artem teaches Nikki Russian, and Nikki is delighted that one of the words sounds like cock.
Shock.
We also find out that all of Artem's family speak no English. This is going to go horribly.
Oh my God, that's just going to be painful.
One of, like, the mum or Johnny, Big Johnny, is going to say something offensive in Russian without realising it. Nikki is trying, and Artem appreciates it when they're in the Russian deli place. We go back to Sedona, and Brie sees Snoopy in the mountains, which was weird. And they go to the shaman and healer, and we kind of hear more about Brian's depression and how society expects him to be happy. And I don't think it's spoken, it wasn't probably what's spoken about. I know he's spoken in depth about it after the fact, but it's not spoken enough of, like, the mental effects of him having to, like, retire and not have, like, the guy has been wrestling his entire life and had to retire at his peak and literally sit there and be told, you cannot wrestle, no doctor will clear you, and even if a doctor did clear you, the chances of you being allowed in a ring and doing what you want to do are very, very low. And he talks about being depressed and not feeling good enough, and it's something that really should be looked at, because I feel like that could also be a case why a lot of wrestlers, that when they end up retiring, a lot of sports people, when they end up retiring, I think it's not the mental aspect is probably worse than the physical. That's why a lot of them end up kind of going off the rails and making silly mistakes, because their mind's been set on one thing, and if they haven't got that oomph in them oomph's a poor choice of word, if they haven't got that thing in them to be like, right, let's try something else, then it's going to be, you can go down a dark hole. It's one of those things. We see the healing stuff, and we get a lot of shots of wind chimes, because I don't know why. But then Bryan, like, in floods of tears, and I think he, like, reaches spiritual enlightenment or something. Like, I don't know what happened here. He got very upset and very emotional, and he said that he basically went...
I think it's one of them... I've never been to one of those places, but I've... And they do say that what happens is they kind of coach. So when you've got depression, you have a sense of you build up a lot of stuff. Even though you do speak about it, you build it up. And these type of places, they're designed so you go there, and they basically, they don't force you, is the wrong word, but they coax it all out of you. So everything comes out. So in that moment, all of his emotion that he's ever felt throughout his depression is just unleashed.
Yeah, it's like one of those things of, like, you know when people do massages and you can, like, release a channel. It's one of the, like, channels and stuff. Like, it's probably one of them where it releases a channel. And he talks about how he's, like, floating above all of them, observing himself, basically letting it all out in one go, talking about how he resents himself. This was, like, all that insane to watch in person. And, again, that's probably one of those things based off the retirement. Like, he resents the fact that his body gave out on him almost. And it's...
Yeah,
very interesting to witness. He talks about a weight being lifted off, and because of that, they finally talk about open up, and they talk about their problems, and it's like the fact that Brian's almost been brought into this crazy, like, crazy manic life of the Bellas, and he just wants a simpler life. He wanted to be quite nihilistic. I remember talking about WWE, like, he doesn't own a television, he's a vegan. It's like, he's a very simplistic man that likes his gardening and his wrestling, and that's about it. They talk about their feelings and how much they love each other. So it's very, very sweet. And they are back on the same page. They're no longer in different library districts. They've met back in the same library, in the same section, picked up the same book, and they're reading the same page again, which is nice. We then cut to Nikki and Birdie trying to hide in a table from Artem. Was Nikki wearing an aunt jumper so Birdie knows it's not mum?
Yes, I think that was like a designer... freaking aunt jumper,
which is pretty good. Like,
do you reckon they do actually get confused? Do you reckon Birdie actually gets confused one's which?
Or I don't want to be that guy, and I am going to be that guy. There are two quite big reasons how, like, Birdie could probably tell which one's Brie and which one's Nikki.
Well, so it's not just that, though, is it? Nikki's had a lot of work done. Like, you never used to be able to tell the difference, but you can now.
Yeah, but it's, and also I imagine that as a daughter, you probably would just know. I don't know anyone that has twins as, like, their mum and their auntie, so...
I know one of the guys I work with, he's a twin, and his son can't tell the difference between him and his brother.
It's because boys are idiots. Never forget that. We are a stupid gender. And Artem is a tremendous actor, great selling in his hide-and-seek, solid work rate. He then fits in the table, and Nikki talks about how amazing of a dad he could be. And then again, Birdie is just a savage because he asks, Berber, Coco be a good mum? You're going to be an all right mum.
Yeah, you're right.
She is not willing to put her neck on the line with this. She's just like, you could be a potentially an okay mum. That's all I'm saying on this. And then there's more faith healing with Brie and Bryan. They go to this more shaman place. And why do all female faith healers all sound exactly the same? They're like very high-pitched voices and very, very happy and talk very breathy like this.
It's because it's the calming voice, isn't it? You're not exactly... Imagine if you was to go to a healer, sit down with me, like, right, mate, we're going to talk about your feelings. Get them off.
Yeah, Naboo from the Mighty Boosh.
Oh, my God.
He had that voice. Oh, I just want to be like, oh, this... I'm a shaman. Come sit down. Let's read these cards. We talk about. I imagine that happened a few seasons back, where Brian had this mental breakdown and just, like, left to go to Washington without telling Brie for, like, 3 months when they were dating. And they open up about what they love about each other, and it's very, very, and it's very, very sweet. We then jump back to their garden as Brian and Birdie are picking spinach. Brie comes out and Birdie just goes, fuck this, look at my playset, and goes and plays on that. I love that. He's like, with spinach, mum comes out. He's like, oh, mum's here. I haven't got to pretend to be interested in this. I'm going to go on my slide.
I have been saved.
Brie talks about how amazing Brian is. Then Brian starts doing pull-ups on the jungle gym because he's showing off. Another jump cut. We now go to a bar where Artem and Brie are getting a drink, and Artem has told Brie that he's got a ring. He bought a ring. He said he bought the ring because the interview with like this flirty dancing show went well. And I was like, it's a bold move to expect that you've got the job. But the interview went well, so I bought a £14 million ring.
Yeah, it was a bit OTT,
wasn't it? I was Googling to see if this thing show actually went to air. I think it did, but I didn't think it went past the season. Because we had...
What was it called?
Flirty Dancing. Apparently it was over here first, and then the US nicked it. Our one had diversity in it, for reasons.
Oh, that's why I've never heard of it.
Brie says to avoid...
Oh, it's still going?
Yeah, apparently so. Like, I couldn't find... Thing is, though, when I put in Flirty Dancing US, the first thing on Google Answers was cancelled. Like, 30 photos, is it been cancelled? And no one gave me an answer. So I imagine it's still a thing. Brie says to avoid drama, he needs to talk to Mum. And also, I'm pretty sure they just catch you up in that Artem is leaving for France tomorrow. The ring's in Phoenix. They're not in Phoenix, so Brie's got to bring the ring with her to France. I can imagine... that's not going to go horribly wrong at all. And Brie is nervous because Nikki... and Brie's nervous for this whole engagement. Don't worry, Brie. Nikki says yes. Spoiler alert. So next week, I imagine, is the mid-season finale, possibly. Or maybe it's the end of the season. I hope not.
No, I think it's mid-season.
Oh, yeah, because they've not actually... No one's announced that they're pregnant yet. We know that happened at some point, yeah. I think. So next week, France, engagements, and much, much more on Total Bellas.